think I'm perfect. Perfect, perfect, perfect. Bitches perfect. Perfect, perfect, perfect. I'm perfect.
Yo guys, what's up? It's Mike, and in this week's video, I'm going to be talking about PCOS. No, I'm not an idiot. I do know that I have another video on my channel about PCOS, but after a few questions and comments on that and on Tumblr, I thought that it would be a good idea to discuss how everything's been for me, considering I'm on testosterone now and I'm seeing some changes. If you have no idea what PCOS is or what the hell I'm even talking about, I really suggest that you go down into the description below and click on the link of my last video, because it talks about how you get diagnosed, the symptoms, and even the medications that you can use. So for all you lazy people who don't want to do that, let me give you a little background information about what PCOS is. PCOS stands for polycystic ovarian syndrome, and it is a metabolic disorder that leaves cysts on your ovaries all over them. They can burst. It's very painful. Doesn't happen to everybody, but it can happen, and usually you end up in the emergency room, and it's pretty bad. It hurts like a bitch, so not fun. This is a big issue because it causes a hormone imbalance and really affects the way that your body reacts to insulin. After going to the doctor, looking online, and even talking to trans people, I was really curious about whether PCOS had anything to do with being transgender, and I found no information that proved that it did have any relevance, so I would say that it does not. But don't trust a college student, because I'm not a doctor, so take it with a grain of salt. Personally, my relationship with PCOS is pretty crappy. I consider it a love-hate relationship, though. Being pre-T and having increased testosterone was awesome at the time, but now I don't get my period. I don't have to worry about the extra testosterone. So it kind of sucks, because you have things like weight gain, acne, and before I had heavy menstruation. Clearly, I'm not the skinniest person, so going into Fenway Health and talking to the doctor with my family there, a major thing was my weight. It was a big concern, not even for the testosterone and to go on hormone therapy. It was just a concern in general, and I definitely knew that I needed to change my eating and my exercise, especially if, you know, surgery was something that I wanted to do along the line. So that's what I did. I am still losing weight. I'm still focusing on that. It hasn't been easy, but I am managing. Do I think that the testosterone may have helped? Maybe, maybe not, but I wouldn't rely on that. Honestly, you need to better yourself for you, and those changes are going to come along. Don't you worry. It's just a matter of, you know, getting habits in place that are good for you. I was really fortunate. My period stopped after about 2 weeks of being on testosterone. I think I got my period once before it completely stopped. As far as hair growth is, it has been going really well. I was pretty surprised. I could grow a little bit of hair before, but my brother has no facial hair at all, so I did luck out. But that's basically all I got, guys. If you have any questions, please feel free to comment below, or, you know, any of my social media, that works too. I hope you guys had a great holiday with your family. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video.